have a number of concerns. One of the concerns deals with transparency. Our administration has been accused of that. Quite frankly, the lack of transparency in all of this presentation is appalling. What you did as one person of the board, Mr. Patterson, is entirely inappropriate. Totally out of your lane. Our job is to do policy and to hire the superintendent. The superintendent's evaluation will be coming up, and I'm sure that can be brought up again at that point in time, but please, much more briefly. This is not the first time I have heard of accusations for employees. This is the first time it has been in this public a setting. Entirely inappropriate. One of the comments made by other board members in other districts, when I go to meetings, said, well, you know, one thing Saginaw Public is really good at, throwing all of the dirty laundry out there. We try to hide ours and take care of it so that things run smoothly in the district. And this is a really good example of laundry. I know Ms. McCray has left. I believe she is absolutely, totally correct. We have seen an amazing example of bullying tonight. And it's not the first time. And there are a number of employees who have left the district because of that. We see a lack of respect. Dr. Roberts, I apologize. You earned your doctorate.
Thank you.
I try very hard to either address you as Dr. Roberts or Assistant Superintendent Roberts. If I address you differently, I apologize. As some people say, it's an error of the head and not the heart.
Thank you.
I will apologize to Dr. Whiston in his absence. He is not a mister. He has earned his doctorate, and it is not whatever you call it. Whiston, W-H-I-S-T-O-N. The state superintendent of instruction. Would be nice if we got his name right. Superintendent McLean. He doesn't have a doctorate yet, but he does have a title, and God knows he's earned it. I found it interesting. I'm trying really hard not to read anything into it, but to call Senator Horn, Mr. Horn, and forget that Ms. Guerrera is a representative. That seems to be disrespectful. They've both been in their particular offices for the same amount of time. If we're talking about a loss of students, one of the reasons we're probably losing students is because of the conduct of this table. you're going to rebut me on all of these points. I expect. Our community deserves better. Our community deserves a Board of Education that takes care of business, takes care of policy, and takes care of superintendent hire, fire, and evaluation. That's our job. It's not our job to call the media, particularly when we're one of seven. I know my phone has been working because I've been getting phone calls. And I realize that, Mr. Patterson, when you were elected, you said that you were looking forward to being the president for the entire board. I guess that wasn't true either. I find out about this tonight. I got all of the information. I read it. They were working on a solution. I'm happy to let them work on the solution and bring the finished solution to us. I don't think it is our job to go into the weeds. All of the classes I have taken, board responsibility, policy, and we hire, fire, and evaluate the superintendent. That's it. We don't need to do gotchas for employees. If employees need to be got, that's the administration's job. It is not our job. We have a recommendation for the HR report. I am appalled that anyone at this table would suggest that somebody resign when that recommendation hasn't come to us. There are legal ramifications. I am hoping that there are no lawsuits over this for character assassination. It's possible. But to talk, now I've talked maybe 10 minutes, but to talk for over 40 minutes and end up with a zinger for an employee is entirely unprofessional and inappropriate. And I am finished for this evening, and Mrs. Seals, I believe, is called on next.
Well, thank you for running the meeting, Ms. Knapp. Ms. Knapp. Ms. Seals.